Cyathea cooperi has become known as the Australian tree fern. This is a little bit of a misnomer, as Cyathea Australis has a much wider distribution, and Dicksonia Antarctica is also more widely found. Cyathea cooperi is also known as the Lacy tree fern, the coinspot tree fern, and the scaly tree fern, as well as Cooper's tree fern. It is native to Australia and found in New South Wales and Queensland. It's the second most widely grown of the Australian tree ferns. The most common is Dicksonia antarctica. But back to Cyathea cooperi, or Australian tree fern if you like, and Robin from Fern Acres Nursery is here to tell us all about it.
The cooperi is a magnificent tree fern that has a very large umbrella canopy of foliage. The trunk is quite distinctive, with scarring from the old frond stems. The old fronds will self-shed, like most Cyathea species, which is good as the growth of the tree fern is quite impressive. This example in our nursery is 16 to 17 years old and is obviously beyond the reach of removing the older fronds. Most Cyathea species will self-shed older foliage, while Dicksonias tend to form a skirt of old fronds. This tree fern is not suitable to grow in areas where snow is common and freezing conditions in winter will kill it very quickly. It is a very large tree fern that will grow in quite exposed areas as long as its root system is somewhat shaded and it has plenty of availability to moisture. It's just one of those ferns, when they're in the pot in the nursery, people pick them up until we show them what they grow into, and then they put them away because they're too large for most suburban backyards, unless you have a specific particular interest in this tree fern.
Well, that one's got to be 5 metres tall.
Yeah.
And how many years did you say?
15 to 16 years.
Yeah.
With good water supply, and this one would be bigger, except we're in an alpine area, so we do need to grow it under a tree canopy. But if this were in a more temperate or less temperate climate, it would grow much quicker as well. It likes a little bit of sun exposure and will grow beautifully with that. But here in King Lake, the winters are too harsh for it, and like most Cyatheas, it's coming into its flush time, so it's putting on 5 or 6 new fronds, which you won't be able to capture on camera, but it will then produce fronds all the year round as well.
If you're looking for a much smaller growing tree fern, then maybe the Silver Lady fern is the one for you, Blechnum gibbon, and we have a separate video on that one. For more information about a whole range of tree ferns, a whole range of ferns, and indeed a whole range of gardening plants, subscribe to the YouTube channel. And as always, good luck with your gardening.